book's called The Restricted View, and when I started writing these poems, the sense of life and theatre, so restricted view as in the cheap seat, was very strong. And the next couple of poems that I'm going to read really have that to the fore. The understudy chooses her moment with a whisper of a sore throat, a twisted ankle, a tendon plucked out of place, tenderly as a heavy stem. The understudy chooses a long night with a hiss you can't dismiss, the radio left on, persistence that stabs like a piece of broken mirror. Lucky for her, with her blue, blue eyes, cold and bright as the morning sky, or stolen starling eggs, obvious, a stain of pollen or yolk on your dress, a stain that clings the way she does, levelly. Stretching herself along the bar, she warms up too. I'm fine, you mutter, as she unfurls a leg, slow and delicate as a petal, the flowers she'll send to you, tucked up in bed. Huge lilies, just in case you think you're funereal, just in case you feel half dead. I'm fine, you snap, sudden as a broken stem, or the thud on the mat of letters and scripts, offers of character parts, voiceovers and crowd scenes, loud as the crunch underfoot, broken bottles, fag ash on the floor, the flute she tilted at you, her star and bubbles rising. Here's to us, she mouthed, and admired her reflection in your eyes, glassy and wet with fear of extinction. And I think in this next poem, life and theatre, life and film get tangled in a way that's a bit more light-hearted. Woody Allen filmed one of his less good films opposite where I was living. And he called it the Fall Project, and the idea of falling became interesting to me, as opposed to fall as in Oram, London, whenever it was. The Fall Project. The whole house taken over, big balloons carried in, bigger maybe than from the florist on the corner of Ladbroke Grove, more croissants eaten standing around than the Buy Best rip-off store could possibly pass off, shriveling as their own. But maybe even they are coping, thriving on the cigarette demands, smoked into the small hours, in the shadows by the extras and runners, around the lamp that makes a pool of evening light last well into the night. All day with bottles of Evian, the leads sit on the wall, in clothes that could be vintage from over the road, except 50s-ish, they look too new. Like the house, which now I come to think of it, they have been cleaning up, whitening like teeth all year. All year to get to now, the moment someone shouts holding, and the grubby street falls still, like one big pause, long enough for something to click, but only in the movies, when really, it takes longer. And when it does, I wake still thinking of you to find Woody Allen's moved in across the street, making his latest untitled, The Fall Project, making it up as he goes along, freewheeling with trucks and cars and florist and the van for dinner, parked over from where, behind the geraniums, I sit with coffee and the papers. All day in yellow jackets, men worry, their brows like sums that don't add up, trying to force days into long enough for a sweating couple in a suit and gold-trimmed skirt to say all there is to say, just so. The sun's still burning when pale on blue, for real, a full fat moon slides out. July will be August by the time they're done. I mean, the light and long nights, the summer will be gone.